How do I remove malware that blocks downloads? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Right into the question. I'm trying to fix a computer that has malware preventing me from getting into regedit and task manager. It will not let me boot into safe mode. It will not let me install any anti-spyware or antivirus software. I'm not sure where to go from here. It has stopped me from doing much of anything to get the malware off the computer. Any suggestions? Sadly, this is all too common. It is a case where malware tries to interfere with your attempts to remove malware. So the problem, of course, is that malware can sometimes go into what you might call self-preservation mode. It tries to prevent you from getting rid of it. And that can take many different forms, from just weird behavior to preventing you from being able to even run your anti-malware tools to preventing you from downloading anything. There are some approaches to try and get rid of it. We do have to get a little creative. The first thing I recommend you do, especially in Windows 10, is to run Windows Defender offline. Now, it used to be a separate download for prior versions of Windows, but in Windows 10, it's built in. And I'm going to show you real quick how to run what they call an offline scan. So we're going to hit the start button here and search for, surprisingly, offline scan. You can see it says virus and threat protection system settings. Fine, that's exactly what we want. We'll bring that up. Click on scan options. That's this item here right below quick scan. And then we will change this not to a full scan or a custom scan, but to a Microsoft Defender offline scan. What that will do, and I'm going to go ahead and start it, though I'm not going to wait for it to finish. What that will do is actually reboot the computer out of Windows and into, I believe, one of the recovery partitions that's on your machine. When it does so, it's able to basically run Windows Defender without the operating system running. More importantly, it's running it without the malware running. By doing so, the malware that's trying to prevent itself from being removed doesn't have the opportunity to do that. So running Windows Defender offline, or Microsoft Defender offline, whichever they're calling it this week, is the very first thing I would have you do in a situation like that. There's a very good chance, especially with the fact that Windows security has become so much better in recent years, there's a very good chance that it will just take care of the issue and remove it for you. After it's done, it'll reboot, and hopefully the malware will be gone. If that doesn't work, the next thing to do is to what I call temporarily kill the malware. The folks over at bleepingcomputer.com have created a tool called RKill, which actually looks for the malware running and kills it, stops it from running, which is another way of preventing that malware from preventing you from doing anything. Now, there are two things of note here. One is, yeah, if your malware is preventing you from downloading something, you're not going to be able to download it, at least not on that computer. You'll want to use a different computer, probably, to download it, copy it to a USB drive, and then take it over to the computer you're having problems with. The second is that RKill has a reputation, and malware may very well be looking specifically for that name and prevent you from running anything called RKill. So you may need to rename that file to something else.exe and then run something else. Once you've run it, don't reboot, because everything it does will be undone by rebooting. What you need to do then is immediately run your anti-malware tools. Do a complete scan immediately after having run RKill and see if now your scans will be able to run, for one thing, and second, be able to remove the malware that you're having problems with. The next thing I would have you try is to download and run the free version of Malwarebytes anti-malware. Yes, there is a free version. They push their paid version very heavily, but you can still get their free version and run it and do what you need to do in a case like this. So my recommendation is grab a copy of Malwarebytes free version or the free trial and run that. See if it can get something. Again, because your malware is preventing you from downloading anything, you may need to download Malwarebytes on a different machine and then take it over to the machine you're having a problem with. Next thing, try another tool. Now, by this, I mean, there are other tools, sometimes from the anti-malware tool vendors themselves, that will run from a bootable CD or DVD or USB stick. I don't have any listed here, but what I would have you do is to go out to the manufacturer of whatever antivirus tool or anti-malware tool you're using and see if they don't also offer some kind of a standalone bootable version of their tool that will do the same thing as Windows Defender Offline will do. It'll reboot into a situation where Windows itself is not running and then run the anti-malware scan. Look for a couple of those, see if those can't solve the problem for you. If nothing works, nothing we've tried so far works, there's not really a lot of other options left. You might remove the hard disk and take it to a different machine that is working and run anti-malware scans using that other machine on this drive that you've taken over. Probably put into an external hard disk case. My recommendation would be to do that. And that way you can run anti-malware scans on it. You can back it up. You can do all sorts of different things to it without the software, the malware that's on it actually running. You must be careful not to accidentally infect the machine that you're doing this with. But that would be, I'd call it the last resort. The true last resort, of course, is the nuclear option where you just throw up your hands. You somehow back up the machine if you don't have a backup already, and you reinstall Windows from scratch. That'll get rid of the malware. It'll also get rid of all your installed programs and your data, so you'll really be starting over from scratch. Now, I do have to, in full disclosure, make you aware of something that would have made all of this a non-issue. And that's a backup. If you had a full image backup of the machine taken prior to whatever this infection happens to be, you would simply restore that backup and get on with your life. Really, it is that simple. And it's one of the reasons that I harp on backups so much, because we've talked about a lot of different steps here, a lot of different and confusing steps that may or may not even work. A backup taken prior to your infection can always be restored to take you back to that point in time. It needs to be a full image backup of the entire machine, but that is exactly what a full image backup is. It's a snapshot of your machine at a particular point in time prior to the malware having happened. It doesn't actually get much simpler than that. Hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully this might, well, scare you a little bit into backing up a little bit more religiously. Daily, perhaps, would be my suggestion. For updates, for related links, for more commentary on all of this, visit askleo.com/4686. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.